Students, this is Kaushika from StudentIn. Today we'll be seeing how to start with HTML. So what is HTML? HTML stands for Hypertext Markup Language. With this help of Hypertext Markup Language, we'll be able to create websites. Let us see how it is being created. Let us take an example of making a cake. So what are the ingredients needed to make a cake? We need sugar, flour, milk, salt, egg, and etc. Same as a HTML code will need several kind of tags. And each tag has a specific task to do. And all these tags will help us to make an HTML code. So when we make a cake, we'll take the ingredients and mix it together. Similarly, when we have to write a HTML code, we need to use all these tags. So, what is tags in HTML? All the HTML tag is enclosed with this bracket, which is less than symbol and greater than symbol. This bracket will be used to write a tag. So each HTML tag will have both starting and ending tag. For example, every HTML will start with HTML tag. So how you will write is, open the bracket and write the tag name. Here the tag name is HTML and close the bracket. This is the starting tag of a HTML tag. And how you will write the ending tag? Ending tag is similar to the starting tag, where you have to insert a slash before the name of the tag. So open the tag, insert a slash and followed by a tag name and close the tag. And this HTML language is not a case sensitive language, which means it does not differentiate between uppercase letters and lowercase letters. So capital HTML is same to the lowercase HTML. These both will be the same. The HTML will not differentiate between capital letters and the small letters. Now we'll see how to create the website. First, what you're going to do is open the notepad in your computer. This is the screen which will appear. And in the notepad, you're going to type the HTML code. This is the first code which we'll be typing. It is called Hello World. Usually every programming language, we do the first code as Hello World. So the same thing is being done here. Can you see here? Our HTML code is starting with HTML tag and it is ending with closing tag of HTML tag. So in between we have head tag, and inside head tag we have title tag, and after that we have body tag. In body tag we are printing Hello World. Let us see what happens. So HTML tag, what this will tell is any text that is enclosed within starting tag of HTML and the ending tag of HTML, the browser will consider this as HTML code. With the help of this tag only, we can tell the browser that this part of the text belongs to HTML code. And the browser will also treat that as HTML language. After that, we saw head tag. This head tag will contain header information such as title and few links. Inside HTML, we will have title tag. Just remember this thing, title tag will always come in between the starting tag of head tag and the ending tag of head tag. So the text which you are going to enter between this title tag will be the title of your web page, will be displayed on the left corner of your browser. And body tag, this tag will contain the main content in the browser. Let us see here. Now we are going to save the HTML file with .html extension, or you can use .htm extension. Why it is necessary to save it as .html extension is that then only our browser will treat it as HTML file. If you're not specifying this HTML extension, it will be saved as text or other formats of file, and we can't execute this file in our browser. Can you see here? this is our code, and we have saved it as hello world.html. So how can we see our HTML code in website? We have to follow a few steps. I'm going to tell you those steps. Open your internet browser. Never mind what browser you're using, and it can be any version you want. And you have to click the Alt button on your keyboard. After you click Alt button, you will get this menu bar. And in menu bar, just click the file option. You will get a drop-down box. In the drop-down box, search for open. Click open and you will get a message box like this. In this message box, just type the path of the HTML file that has been saved in your computer and click OK. So after you've done this, you will see that Hello World is getting printed, and our title, which we gave is My First HTML, is getting displayed as the title of our web page. There is an alternate way to see our HTML code in web page. Let us see how it is being done. So these two steps we have already done, which is we are going to open a notepad. We are going to type the code, and we have also saved it with .html extension. After that, what you are going to do, after you have saved the file, just right click on your file. So when you right click on your file, what will happen is you will get a drop down box and click open with browser menu. Then you will automatically see your output of HTML code. Let us see another example. Here are a few tags. This is the page you will get when you open Google, right? This is the homepage of Google. This is called the image tag. And the text box where you will ask question, like where you type in question, this is called the text box tag. And below the text box tag, you have two button, and this button is called button tags. And below the page, you get this hyperlink tag, wherein you click this text, you will be taken to other web page. Now we are going to look into attributes of a tag. Let us see what is this attribute and why it is so important. Attribute means quality. Now see, what is this? What is this fruit this boy is holding? It is an apple, right? Can you tell me any quality of apple? Apple is red in color, and it is rich with vitamins, fibers, etc. These are the attributes of an apple. Let us see the attributes of our tag. So what is attribute? Attribute is a special keyword which will be in the opening tag of a tag. Any tag, let it be any tag. It will be lying within the opening tag of any tag in HTML. And what this keyword will do is it will specify the behavior of the element. Element here is the tag. Body tag is an element, and the keyword background will describe the behavior of this body tag. So background will contain the image of the background of a web page, and BG color is and other attribute of body tag, which will define the color of the background. ID is an other attribute, which will be the name of the body tag. So these are the attributes. As I told you, BG color will define the background color of an entire web page. And background will set background image to our web page. And ID, this ID is used in searching tags programmatically. To this, we come to the end of the session. Let us look into what we have seen. To sum up, what is HTML? HTML stands for Hypertext Markup Language. With this help of this language, we'll be able to create web pages. And we learned how to create a very simple Hello World program, which we did it in Notepad. Then we learned about attributes and tags. And we also saw the HTML structure, where we saw the uses of HTML tag, head tag, body tag, and title tag. I hope you had a really good session. Happy learning. Bye.